Well, good evening. It's Sunday evening. It's just gone 8:30 and it's the 22nd of May 22. And welcome to Shine a Light with me, Bishop Desmond. Your Bishop Desmond. And we're giving God thanks that we are here today. Responsibility is an important thing. Take responsibility for our actions. Take responsibility for what has happened around us. And if you take on a task, you've got to be responsible for that as well. Maybe too many peoples are often in positions of leadership, but when as push comes to shove, as we call it, they want to put the blame on others. And we've seen what's been happening in our community. We've seen the case of D. John Reed and the truth coming out about what really happened. And now the concern and outrage in some departments of what has happened and how the whole scenario was, there was an attempt to cloud it. And you have many people who don't want to take responsibility for their actions. And that's the first thing you've got to do, because sometimes, you know, when you're seeking forgiveness, the greatest thing you can do is actually say, well, listen, I did it, or I got it wrong, or it was a moment of madness, whatever. But we don't get that. What we get are excuses, spin and euphoria. And by getting that, what happens is things just continue. There are no changes and never will be no changes, because there are times when we just refuse to take responsibility for our actions. What a wonderful world it would be if we just took responsibility for our actions. But many people don't want to do that. Many people aren't interested in that. They're not interested in taking responsibility for their actions. They rather point fingers. Even as a community, we have to take responsibility. Take responsibility in supporting the family of D. John Reed. You've seen the media this weekend. Now you know the horrific trial his mother had to sit there and endure. And many people are sitting in judgment. Now you've seen it. Now's the time to support. She's got a petition to change juries at change.org. There's a petition to bring back a civil rights act, or bring a civil rights act forward that protects people of color. Bring back a race relations act. That's what we need. There's a petition at change.org for that. And also the Just Giving campaign, because to run a campaign, you need money. Support them. Let us take responsibility for helping the family of D. John Reed get justice. We don't want excuses. We just need to be doing what is right. Many of us say we know what is right, but do we know what is right? That's the thing. For far, far too long, too many people just want to be popular. Doing what is right is not popular. Standing by the truth is not popular. Not in this society in which we live, folks. But until we take responsibility and face the hard, cold, hard truth, really, where are we going? Where are you going? Where are any of us going? I'll tell you where we're going. We're on the road to nowhere for the simple reason we don't want to take what we're doing seriously. We don't want to take what we have to do. We don't want to take the responsibility and the burdens that we bear seriously. But when it comes hammering on our front door, all of a sudden, we're all on it. But let me tell you this tonight, folks, as we shine a light, let this be a light where we collectively start playing our part in bringing about the changes that need to be made. Let us collectively do what is right. Let us collectively do the right thing. Let us collectively stand firm and stand on the promises that we are to be standing upon. And those are the only promises we can stand upon are the promises of God. So tonight, as we shine this light, we shine this light, a light of love, a light of peace, a light of grace, a light of unity, a light of responsibility, so we are there for each other. Let us be able to lean on each other and let us do what is right. So let us tonight shine this light in order to make a difference in this world. We have so many things happening. We hear shenanigans in government again about Partygate. We've got so many other things going on. But if the house ain't in order, how can they sort any place else out? How can we be talking about being a city of sanctuary or a nation of sanctuary when we're kicking people out? Or sending people who seek asylum to Rwanda. I didn't know that Rwanda was in the UK. But do you know something? It'll be interesting to see the skin colour of those that are sent to Rwanda. People, it's time that we unite and do what is right. If we don't, this uneven level of racism that exists will only manifest. And before you know it, it'll just be one mass disaster zone. So as we shine this light tonight, let us shine this light of change, a light where we can make a difference. The words of the reckless pierce like swords, but the tongue of the wise bring healing. Gentle words are a tree of life, a deceitful tongue crushes the spirit. If anyone thinks he is religious and does not bridle his tongue, but deceives his heart, this person's religion is worthless. Let your conversations always be full of grace. Some verses there from Proverbs, James, and Colossians. But tonight, let us just stand by the promises and the words that God has given to us. Because someone has to take leadership. Someone's going to take the reins in order to make a difference. Heavenly Father, the hope, Father, we have in you is immense. Father, we continue to pray that you just let your light of hope shine upon us and not bring us to harm. Father, help us to build up and not tear down. Father God, help us to deliver life and not death. Father, let us take responsibility for not just our words, but our actions. Father, our lips will speak goodness, but our hearts at times say something different. Father, set our hearts, our minds, our affections on things that you have taught us, so that our thoughts and our hearts and affections sit at the right hand of you. Father, thank you for bringing Jesus into our lives. Father, we know that it brought forgiveness, righteousness, and citizenship in heaven. Father, no matter what else is going on in our world, upon you we stand. You give us the riches beyond measure, riches that have no price tag. Peace beyond understanding and life truly abundant. Father, we praise, we honor and adore your name. Father, may the good news win hearts, win minds, win souls for your kingdom. Father, every day we experience difficulties and difficult people, challenges, relationships, diversions. Father God, our limitations, feeling as though they've been cut of times, Father. People going round a cycle, Father, of reoffending. But Father, it is always your desire to respond with mercy and grace, as opposed to acting out of anger. So Father, we abandon ourselves to you. We leave everything at the foot of the cross. And Father, we let the power of the gospel and the ministry of your Holy Spirit move amongst each and every one of us. Father, may the words of our mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in your sight. My God, my Redeemer, grant us mercies, we pray, Father God, and let us journey with you and you alone. We ask for these blessings right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Well, folks, remember this week at Panocroft Village, our empowerment with Minister Jennifer Housen. That's this Wednesday, 7:30. Our Saturday morning breakfast for men's empowerment, 9 a.m. at Panocroft Village with Deacon Keith Panton. And also next Sunday, 11 a.m., our Sunday service at Panocroft Village. This is Bishop Desmond Jadu thanking you for joining us whilst we shine this light. A light of hope, a light of grace, a light of harmony, but most of all, a light of responsibility. So we stand upon the promises that God has given us, and we do what is right. Have a wonderful week in the Lord. God bless you.